Minister.
Hi, I'm Sue Sacker for Deputy CEO of Schizophrenia Fellowship.
And what program are you going to talk about? The Mental Health Sports Network?
We're going to talk about the Mental Health Sports Network today, which is not, it's auspiced by the Fellowship, but actually is a sort of sector program and that has support of many other community managed organisations and state government departments. So it's a fledgling new organisation evolving out of a previous Mental Health Sports Association, which many of you will remember, into a new statewide organisation for sport and physical activity.
And have you got something for us to look at? They're going to put something on the wall.
That's the other
program. Oh, we're not talking about that now. Okay, we can just leave it up there behind us anyway.
So there is
this is the new poster hot off the press, and there is a website which should come up and some presentations there.
So hold your poster up higher so we can stare at it.
Actually, I can. That's all right.
So it says, are you game? Sport is a fun way to get fit. Choose from 10 pin bowling, cricket, softball, table tennis and volleyball. Beginners welcome, meet new people and make new friends. Annual membership, $10 per person. So where do you get involved?
There's a website. It's only launched by the Minister for Sport in April. And there's a website, mentalhealthsports.org.au. And there are membership forms outside, actually. So anybody can join as an individual member, and programs join as program members. And so the point of the network is that it's not us, so it's not the actual network offering the sport, but it's a network of sporting activities across the state. So we will organise competitions and things like that, but we really, it's a vehicle for anybody to get involved in sport, whether you're an individual or a program.
And do you have to have a mental illness?
It is the Mental Health Sports Association, but you know, feel free. I don't think that's a major issue. We're not going to ask you your diagnosis at the door, we're not like that.
Well, I suppose sometimes, if we could just jiggle sideways, because we have, I need to go to the others, but Sue, is there anything else you'd like to add that we haven't said about the Mental Health Sports Network?
I just encourage you to have a look at the website and join. It is a bit fledgling, it has just been launched, as I say, in April, so do join in, and it's a great way to help people with people with mental illness to address the barriers. Because of, you know, why don't you just go to sport at the gym? Why don't you go and join the local club? There are barriers, we know that. So this is a way, that pathway through the sports network to the wider community of sport, as Wayne is a perfect example of, so that it's not about creating just our own world, but it's about entering into the wider world. And I just wanted to thank all the foundation members. We have 9 foundation members from the sector, as well as New South Wales Health and New South Wales Department of Sport and Recreation. So we hope, it's a shame Tim's gone, but we hope there is hope,
yes,
and there is a future driven by the community managed sector, not by the so much by the clinicians.
That's right, and there is hope. It's funny you say that. I've interviewed Tim Lambert at a number of events, and he's clearly passionate. But he, and again, I don't mean to be disrespectful in his absence, but there's often an aside of despair, if I could say that. And how do you keep your optimism? You've been involved for many years. How do you bat on and stay positive? Is it sport?
The what keeps you going, and everybody in this room, I'm sure, will agree, is the individual success stories, the families and the individuals who take their life and they make what they want of it.
Yeah.
So any of us are working in it as managers or support workers or whatever, that's what makes us get up in the morning.
Yes.
And I think that the I've been passionate about physical health for a long time. I have a physical nursing background, and when I see the neglect that happens, like Tim, I'm as angry as Tim about it, and I share his despair in many ways, but we can make some small steps through programs, all our programs, as a lot of you do, run physical health components, we can do that some more, and to address those issues, and they are appalling, as we know. We just have to take one step at a time and keep addressing them and working towards making it better until it is really mainstream, and then we can all relax.
Now, Sue, have you got a cord?
A cord?
Do you know the expression, a cord?
No.
No, so I just was going to ask her to do a plank. She just looked like the kind of girl who could. We'll come back to that later. I'll explain it during lunch. But I recently...
Don't make me sing.
Police conference. I literally had a room of 600 police, and I said, who can do push-ups? And we had this debate. I had lines of women doing push-ups because police have to be fit. It was thrilling. So,
I do a good shavasana.
What's a shavasana?
Anybody do yoga shavasana when you lie down at the end and get a rest?
No. Listen, we'll negotiate during lunch, but I promise you, whatever that was, we'll we'll have one from Sunny. Can you give them both a warm round of applause?